Welcome. In this video, I will be computing the expected value and the expected value of perfect information for this payoff table in Excel, given these probabilities for the states of nature. For the expected values, we compute the average of the payoffs for each decision alternative, weighted by the probabilities using the sum product function. So for D1 equals sum product, select the payoffs, comma, and then select the probabilities. Because I want to copy the formula down for other alternatives, I'm going to lock down the probabilities by pressing F4 on the keyboard. Enter. Use the fill handle to copy it down. We can then determine the maximum by using equals max and selecting the expected values. We see that the maximum value is 16.78, and that corresponds to decision D2. Now, perfect information assumes we know with certainty which state of nature will occur. And if we do, we will choose the decision that corresponds with that highest payoff in that state of nature. So if we know that S1 will occur for sure, we will go for the maximum payoff in S1 using equals max and selecting the payoffs for S1. That is, we will go with the 36 and choose D1 if we are certain that S1 will occur. We then copy the formula to other states to determine their maximum values as well. These are the values assuming we have perfect information. The expected value with perfect information, EVwithPI, is thus calculated as the weighted average of these values. So equals sum product, the maximum values, comma, then the probabilities. The expected value of perfect information is now the difference of the expected value when we have perfect information and the expected value when we don't have perfect information. And that's 8.42 in this case. Thanks for watching.